our pal Michael Espinosa coming in with this one. This is a band that I've never heard of before. They're called The Hunger. And I found it. It was a hell of a time trying to find a logo for these guys. These guys must go back in the Wayback Machine. But we're going to learn about the band The Hunger, and then we're going to do the song Vanishing Cream for Michael Espinosa today. So let's get into them. Let's dive in and see what we can learn about this band. The Hunger, they have 23,493 monthly listeners to the Spotify account. The top five jams. Did they just release a new album? The Hunger, self-titled album 2020. And then got Ruining 2 is the latest single. But top five jams they've got here. Therapy, 128,000 plays. And you got Vanishing Cream, the song that we're doing here. 374,977 plays. Then you got Therapy Processor Remix. Are these guys going to have a bit of the industrial? Now that's got 15,000 plays. And you got Running 2. That's that new single. 2,249 plays. Then you got Moments in Misery. And that's got 2,826 plays. And that is from that 2020 album, The Hunger. Let's look into those albums and see what they've done over their career. And it looks like they started in 1996, and it would be this album right here, Devil Thumbs a Ride. Then you've got 1998 Cinematic Super Thug. Cinematic Super Thug, 1998. You got Spaceman's Last Goodbye, 2001. Finding Who We Are, 2005. Grip, 2012. Leave Me Alone, 2012. Okay, the years are all goofed. Tonight / Shoot to Kill. Maybe that's a single of some sort. Then you've got The Hunger from 2020. So they probably took a big break before they decided to get back at it, right? Now what we do is we go down. This is going to give us some telltale signs of who people listen to when they listen to The Hunger and who they might have played shows with. So let's get into that. God Lives Underwater. Bang. That sounds familiar to me because we just did, who did we do? Orgy. We did Orgy last week. And Gravity Kills was one of those bands that popped up. Stabbing Westward was one of those bands. Brother Kane, I've never heard of them. 16 Volt, no. Pig, no. I've heard that word, pig, though. Have you ever heard that? It's a animal, I guess. I don't know. Machines of Loving Grace. Yes, I've heard the name of that. Sister Machine Gun, vaguely familiar. Full Devil Jacket, that's a nice play on words. Godhead, we mentioned them. I said that I saw Godhead open for, I thought they were a local band for some reason, but they opened for Gwar some years ago. You got Push Monkey, and you got Filter. And I like me some Filter. All right, so there you have that. That is the related artist. Now what we do is we go and look into that bio and we read a bit about them. And you got four fellas here, five fellas, pardon me. Black and white photo where they're standing in an alleyway. There's a bit of water on the ground. I don't know if this man in the middle had just taken relieved himself with some urine on the streets or if it was just a damp day, but they're all standing there. The one guy in the black t-shirt, he's standing puffed up and he's looking at me as if to say, Shane, how would you like a nice kick in the nuts? Brothers Wilson, Jeff, and Thomas, who are the original founding members behind the industrial rock band The Hunger. Well, that explains a lot, doesn't it? With Alex Slay drums and Richie Hay bass and Jeff Smith guitar, have returned to release new music for the first time in more than 15 years. So I was right about that, what I said. A self-titled seven-track album. We were literally inspired by the sadness, anger, frustration, and uncertainty of life during the COVID-19 pandemic shutdown, said the brothers. This album relates to drug abuse, alienation, suicide, ultimately hope, all real-life situations we saw friends and family deal with over the last 9 months. So that must be that Hunger album, or maybe it's something that they're preparing to release soon. I don't know, but it is that time. It is time to get into this song for Michael Espinosa, the fantastic Michael Espinosa, card-carrying member of the Uber Elite Shane Diablo Commanders Club, by the way. And we're going to get into Vanishing Cream from this band. And it doesn't ring a bell with me at all. Let's see if it'll ring a bell now. This is the Magic Nipple. And I'm going to give you a taste. I take a taste. We listen together. Sound good? Let's go for it. The Hunger. Vanishing Cream. There's your industrial rock. Playing a stand-up bass. I feel alone. I feel of you. I feel there's nothing I can do. It's getting late. There's no one home. No messages on the telephone. Feels so good today. That picked up, didn't it? Is it weird I hear a little James Hetfield in his voice? Young James Hetfield? It's a swing beat. This is like one of the least industrial songs as far as I would have ever heard in my life. Man, it's not bad, it's just... When I think industrial, I don't think this. You know, it'd be awesome if it was actually James Hetfield singing it. I can definitely hear the filterish influence and the, I guess you call this industrial rock, maybe? Does it get played on the radio? Just Vanishing Cream. You know what those guys did? They used Vanishing Cream for 15 years. Therapy. Processor remix. Come on, turn that son of a bitch off. I want to turn it off now. Yeah, what they did was they bought a big old bottle of that Vanishing Cream, enough to cover five men. And they vanished for 15 years and now they're back. But hey, they're back. There's that, right? Sometimes it takes all kinds of things for a band to get back together again. And these guys say it was COVID-19. They said, hot damn, let's fire it back up. Maybe they had plenty of time to talk to each other, you know. I mean, 15 years is a huge gap. Perhaps they weren't getting along with each other as much. You know, brothers can also not get along, too. Ask those Oasis guys. Jesus. But what say you? Most important part of my videos is not my opinion whatsoever. It has nothing to do with me. It has everything to do with you. Because I and I'm selfish. And I like to go into the comments and read your comments and your thoughts and opinions on The Hunger and the song Vanishing Cream. So you can tell me, good, great, fantastic. Shane, I have seen this band live. Tell me about those experiences that you've seen live. What is your favorite album from the band? Is it this one, Devil Thumbs a Ride? Vanishing Cream, what do you think of that song? Did you see them actually play it live? Have you ever met these guys? What's your favorite album? What's your favorite songs? Have you heard that new album? And what do you think of it? Or you could say, not good, not great. Shane, it was not industrial enough for me. It was more kind of a hard rocking with some computer bits in there. It's not my cup of tea. I'm going to give it a hard pass and say thank you very much for it, but I'm not going to listen to it ever again. All of that can be put in the comments below. If you are like Michael Espinosa, the fine, fantastic guy, and you have a request, click that link in the description below. We'll get it on for you. That's all I've got for this. Now I'm going to get myself some Vanishing Cream.